G'day. So in this video, we're going to turn this steel cage into a concrete column. Stay tuned. This column is 700 by 200 by 3 meters. So we're going to cut the 700 side at 700, and the smaller sides we're going to cut at 236. The ply is 18 mil, so that's why we're 236, so it overlaps. Right, so I'm just gonna nail these off with 50 mil Nailgun nails. What we do in our 700 piece is to hang the ply down 20 mil, so I put a cleat on the bottom, and I let the timber stick out 20 mil as well. Cleat goes on the bottom. Next we put fillet on so we get nice neat corners. Now it's ready to be stood. The reason I put that cleat on is so that now I can fix it down. It's bloody one of those days today where it just keeps on bloody raining. Usually I just go home. A couple drops and I usually just go home. But it's one of those days today where I can't go home. The reason the timber sticks out is so that when this next piece comes here, it's just got something hard to sit to. I always keep my fillet up from the bottom, because when I stand this, if that clips something on the ground, it'll come loose and it can stuff up that first bit of the shutter. So keep it up. You can't get knocked by anything and damage further up. Guys, make sure you let me know in the comments if you love formwork as much as me. You know what the problem with other types of carpentry is? Sanding. You don't have to sand in formwork. You don't have to plane. You don't have to get things millimeter perfect. That's what I think the problem is. Sanding. The reason I use texture and wire for all my fixings in the concrete, there's tie wire laying everywhere when we do this work. So I can forget to bring it, I can forget to buy some, and I'll always have some. Hot tip, use a new timber in the middle. New timbers don't swell up as much. When we put our clamps on, if we have a swollen fat timber in the middle, it's gonna be hard to rest our clamps on there evenly. So get a nice new timber in the guts. It's bloody raining again. This is the small side. We just keep our timbers flush on this one. Flush on the sides. So we don't want to nail this off because when we plumb this, we still need it to be able to move. So what we do is we bang two nails, one there, one the opposite way, and we twist them up. I'll give you a better view of it. Use my nips. Usually I use 3-inch nails, but I don't have any. So this is an example of why nail guns are the gift that just keeps on giving. The paper actually grips and it works really well for this. If you need a bit more, just put another one. I'll give you a little time lapse of me putting these clamps on. Okay, somewhere where a lot of people go wrong with these column clamps is they start putting their wedges in and tightening everything before it's ready. So before you put your wedges in these clamps, just make sure there's no gaps on these timbers. Can you imagine if there is gaps and then you put your wedges in and start tightening it, your clamps aren't going to do up square. So the second thing that's important is to do everything up evenly. Now, I've actually got a problem here. This one needs to pull in. So this is how not to do it, but I'm going to pull this side in first. I'm going to have to fix this. Okay, so I'll fix the issue. I've got it in. I redid all the clamps so there's no gaps anywhere. So now what we do is we do everything up evenly. So I'm going to say to myself, right hand first. So usually you have one person on this side, one person on the other side. So we go right hand first, so we're on the same page. Right hand first. Right hand. Now go the other one. Left. Then what we do is we remember the order we were in. So the next one will be left hand first, then right hand first, left hand first, then right hand first. So what I do now is I put the top clamp on. Okay, so here's the important bit. So often people will get up inside and square up the inside, make sure it's right, and they adjust it by putting the wedges in on certain sides first. That's the wrong way to do it. That's the hard way. I don't square it. If you have your shutter, all your shutters sitting quite nice by twisting the nails, it'll actually be very, very close to square. And then when you put your clamps on, make sure there's no gaps and tighten up your wedges evenly, it's almost always perfect. So never force these in, just sit them in. Now we're going to do them up. So we went right, we're going to go left, right, left, right. So your right hand first. Right hand first. Then we go left. Just inspect all your corners, make sure they're tight. Now is the most important thing. It's something a lot of people forget. The bottom of the column might be square. The top of the column might be square, but they might not be square with each other. Now, really long columns, and especially small ones, like 400 by 400s, they're the worst ones. It can be exaggerated. So here's an example. Here's the bottom of our column. Here's the top of our column, both square, but not square with each other. Okay, twist. So here's how to get rid of it. What you do, eye the front timber with the back timber from bottom to top, and you see if the bottom is sticking out more than the top or vice versa. What I do is I just get a long timber, get something heavy, and I smash the clamp here, and that'll twist the top around, and it works. This is a bit hard holding camera. Let's have a look. Yeah, that's definitely perfect now. All right, let's finish it off so I can go home. I've got a wider span at the top because there's less pressure. I'll probably see out of this on the pour and put an extra one in, but that'll be fine. Now, if you're doing this for yourself, own a builder or whatever, you can hire these clamps from a formwork supplier. And to get your spacings, just tell them your column size. They'll tell you the spacings. If you go 500 centers up to about halfway, and then you can start spreading them from there on. The only other thing we have to do on this column is put props on it and plumb it up. I do that during the pour. I have a little laser and I'll just measure at the bottom, measure at the top until it's perfect. And then I'll put the props in. If I put the props in now, they use scaffold when they pour these. They often rip the props out. Also, when they're vibrating these columns during the pour, sometimes the props will move a little bit. Another thing that happens is sometimes guys climb up on these clamps, shift them a bit, because that's what we're propping to. So, long story short, I prop during the pour. That's how you build a column. Thanks for watching my video. Hope you enjoyed it.